Hey everyone, I'm Michael Majors.
And I'm Todd Anderson.
And you're watching the Versus series on StarCityGames.com. Everyone, today in the Versus series, we're back for some more standard action after Columbus, where Todd may have won.
I doubt it, but but you know, if you call shot every week, it gets a little old. You know, like when you do eventually win, it's just like, okay, well, you know, you called it the last
got
17,
one,
yeah, yeah. So we don't know what happened yet. We're filming this right before SCG Columbus, and personally, I'm looking forward to standard. I think there's a lot of cool things you can be trying to do. I'm really hoping the format doesn't devolve back into Marvel and Mardu vehicles and. What else? What else is there?
Well, it can't devolve back into Emrakul and Smuggler's Copter, so that's great. Or Reflector Major Creature. But yeah, I don't know. It looks like there's going to be lots of like combo stuff, which is really fun.
I mean, it certainly can be fun if the combo is fun, as in like, you know, trying to figure out ways to pick it apart or you know, just like playing the mind game of like, you know, do I hold up this bluff to make sure that they don't go for the combo? And the Felidar Guardian plus the Heliorai combo is obviously something that we're all thinking about and talking about. And I honestly don't think you can play a deck that can't interact with it.
I agree.
Aside from that though, like I think the combo is more than fair. Personally, I haven't played a ton with it or against it, but on paper it doesn't look like it's that bad.
There are certainly ways to beat it, but it's very powerful, not a huge deck building restriction. You can kind of just jam your deck with a bunch of like ETB triggers that work well with Felidar Guardian and Saheeli Rai.
Sure.
My favorite is like Oath of Jace so far. That's a lot of fun. yeah, I think the combo is very powerful, but you know, something as simple as Shock can theoretically keep it in check. So we'll see what happens. On the other end of the spectrum, I'm kind of updating the old boogeyman, Aetherworks Marvel. We're just back and forth with Lamog now.
Yeah, I mean, there's not a whole lot else you can do, right? You need, like, at least four, probably five or six, like, big hits mm-hmm. off of it. You know, a lot of the versions right before the banning, you know, people were playing, like, you know, three Emrakul, two Lamog, and also, like, you know, a couple Chandras, a couple other Planeswalkers, etc. Just to make sure that, you know, they weren't just whiffing most of the time.
Yeah, certainly lots of different ways you could update this deck, but the approach I'm taking today is to include some inspiring statuaries to actually allow you to hard cast Ulamog.
Every week.
And some
just every week, man, just plays inspiring statuaries.
Kurt's just so sweet.
It is sweet. I do like it a lot.
Yeah, we're like kind of backdoor into our Ulamog by making some Thopter tokens with Whirler Virtuoso and Maverick Thopterist, and we're going to cast some Boom Booms. It's going to be fun.
I'm going to be playing a blue-black or black-blue Tezzeret based control deck. This is a deck built by Jerry Thompson. It utilizes artifacts alongside Metallic Rebuke, as well as just like a bunch of removal spells like Fatal Push. And the deck just looked really cool on paper. And Jerry is notorious for building, you know, control decks that just don't function in week one. And I always have to give one of them a spin, especially when they look really sweet. So I'm giving it a shot. I think Tezzeret is a lot better than we initially thought. And if he's able to at least keep up today, then I may consider playing him over the next couple weeks.
Yeah, should be fun.
All right, let's go and get to the match and see who takes it down between Black Blue Tezzeret and Temur Aetherworks. Or Temur Marvel. Whatever.
Poker hand?
Yeah, poker hand. See who goes first. Best poker hand wins. Pair of sixes.
Yeah.
Two pair. Pair of fives.
I did it.
Tilt.
Yeah.
So close. All right, let's go ahead and get some openers.
Some squeaker cheekers.
Squeaker cheekers. That's not a thing. How's your hand, Michael?
My hand is... We're not on plan A or really plan B, but I'm going to keep it.
Yeah, I don't know what my deck's plan A is, really. So, this hand looks certainly playable. We have some cards that cycle and some interaction, so... Might as well. And some lands.
I could use a land or two.
All right. Go. All right. I'll do this just in case.
Ooh, I'm scared now.
Just to bluff it.
Get me some balls and it'll be your turn.
All right, I didn't bluff. I'm just stupid. Got him real good.
I don't know what to say.
All right, I'm going to lose a life. I'm drunk. Right.
Go. I don't know.
Got
if that
him
was,
real good.
I don't know if that was genuine or not. I have no idea.
It took me a second.
Go.
Fine. Oh, that card. Well, I don't have a way to interact with the combo, aka
AK Marvel next turn.
Yeah, Aetherworks Marvel. All right. We'll play this Renegade map, and a 1/1 walking ballista.
All right.
Your turn.
Let's just beat down a little bit.
That's fine. A little Thopter action.
Little Thopter action. Smush you. He wants to block and shoot.
Kind of want
to
block and shoot. This ballista's not getting much better. All right, block here. Kill that. It's not getting a whole lot better. This card is very hit or miss. Sometimes it's insanely good. Early in the game, you know, it's not like a Hangerback Walker where if you untap with it, you can, like, start putting counters on it easily. You know, it's pretty expensive to put a counter on it.
I'm not sure how I want to sequence this turn. I could just do this, or I could do this in combination with either of these two cards. I think we kind of just want to start digging to something powerful, though. So I'm just going to play this, even though it's not particularly mana efficient. Go.
Draw.
Mm-hmm.
Go get an island.
Didn't want to upkeep it?
Nah, I kind of wanted to draw land. And if I did draw land, then I might have used it for whatever.
Improvise,
yeah. All right, I'll play it. I'll cast the Hedron Archive.
Okay.
I'll tap this and play a Prophetic Prism.
Going off.
Go.
All right. I'm going to sacrifice my vessel. There we go.
No! Man.
All right, got Delirium. Feeling good. Gonna go ahead and take this opportunity to get my Marvel down.
Yeah.
Attack you for two.
17.
Go.
All right. Could wait on this, but we're gonna blow that up.
Ooh, an energy.
Get some energy.
And you get a 20.
Yeah. Play this. Your turn.
All right. Go ahead and take my free attune.
Marvel is terrifying.
Getting a... I guess forest. I don't even know how I built my mana base. Probably just 1/1. Sure did.
That's smart. That's just good deck building.
All right, we're gonna play this.
Oh no.
Gain some lives.
So you're at 23.
What should I do now? Could just go ahead and try to bust up Todd with some Ulamog.
No.
Sounds reasonable. Guess we'll do that.
No, don't do that.
All right.
I said wait. Wait until I untap, please.
I don't want you to metallic rebuke me.
I could have not cast Gear Hulk and just held up Rebuke, but...
This is not exciting.
Yeah!
Should I... I'm at 23 now.
Yeah, you're at a million. Don't worry about it.
I wonder if I'm supposed to just put this onto the battlefield. I could just, like, take the safe route and kill Todd's thing.
No, I don't do that.
I think it's actually quite close. I'll just put a vessel into play.
Okay.
And then I'm going to play another Puzzle Knot.
Man, just going off on me, huh?
Be right, 26
and 5 energy.
And your turn.
Michael's just going to get to use that marble for the next 20 turns straight.
Hopefully.
All right, whack ya.
21.
My deck cannot put a lot of pressure on you right now. I guess we'll play Liliana and just tick up. We don't have a whole lot of creatures in our deck, so minusing without a creature in the yard is pretty silly. Oh, I do have a creature in the yard. I forgot about old walking ballista. Yeah, sure. It's more fun.
Yep.
This is a 2/2.
Produce.
And say go.
Okay.
Just hope there's not an Ulamog in this top five spins.
I guess I'm going to start by...
Maybe he's got two Ulamogs in hand.
Playing... maybe I don't want to actually expose this to Metallic Rebuke. That is reasonable. Yeah, I'm going to start by sacrificing my vessel, and I'll get an energy.
Yep.
Might just want to take this hub. I guess Traverse can just get me a... I can't get a Traverse. I don't know what I'm thinking. It's out of my mind.
Yeah, Puzzle Knot.
Could get a Puzzle Knot.
Continue going off forever.
I think I want this hub, though, so I can enable this on the following turn. So I'm going to do that. And now I'm feeling pretty lucky. I'm just gonna go for it. Oh, deck. I'm not doing anything cool. Lame.
No, that's great. I'm having fun. I'm just sweating over here. Every turn I'm just like, well, hope he doesn't hit. Oh, well, hope he doesn't hit. Please don't hit.
Now it might be reasonable for me to just go ahead and do this right here. But where's the fun in that? I'm going to play... Nah, it's probably just the right play. So I can do this, actually, and hold priority and sacrifice a Puzzle Knot so I can actually kill a Gear Hulk. But then it just gets rebuked, but maybe that just doesn't matter. This is actually, like, oddly complicated. Yeah, I'm just going to do that to try to lessen... Well, no, because then I can't Marvel. I'm just hemming and hawing. This is tough. I'm going to play this Whirler Virtuoso.
Okay.
All right, back to 3 energy.
Yep.
Four energy.
Yep.
Play another Whirler Virtuoso.
All right, I'm going to rebuke that one.
Okay. Play this vessel.
Okay.
Go ahead.
All right. Well, I don't think we're going to be able to dodge it forever. Draw.
Odds would dictate. We should be close.
Yeah. I don't play the odds. All right, we're going to battle at the bridge this thing for 3.
Okay, I gain an energy.
All right, so we go 23. And he chose not to activate, which is fine because we had the Liliana. Plus, he wants to make sure he can activate Marvel. Tick this up. I'll just play this for 3 and I hit you for 7.
Okay, I'm at 14.
Your turn.
This is weird. This actually gives me an energy for free, but it's not clear I want to shuffle my deck. I could sacrifice it and respond to the ability by activating Marvel, which actually sounds kind of reasonable. I could also just sack my vessel. I guess we'll just sacrifice my vessel. So I'm going to do that.
Okay.
Where are the Ulamogs? Art thou Ulamog?
Why couldn't that have been Ulamogs off of the vessel?
Okay. Let's do this.
It has to be here. I just hope all of them are here, all 4.
3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Hit an Ulamog.
Okay. Targets.
I'm going to hit. You have no cards in hand?
Nope.
And I'm at 14.
You are at 14.
I'm going to target.
You're technically at 9.
It's true. I'm going to target Hedron Archive and Noxious Gearhulk.
Wait.
And I'm going to play Thopterist, get two Thopters.
Okay.
And Evolving Wilds and say go.
All right, so we have access to six mana. We can crack this puzzle knot. Ballista's not doing... Oh, beat him. Got him.
Oh, man.
Got him good.
Ulamog. Poor Ulamog. It's contained.
Tick up on a Thopter, I guess.
Gaining energy.
Yep. And... Go.
Still don't think I want to shuffle my deck. So I will decline to do so. Guess we'll start by going to combat.
All right, tap your Ulbog. I should have main phased this in case I hit a land. I'm gonna just
22.
Yeah. Play it. Sorry. Relearn.
All right, I'm going to do what I talked about previously. I'm going to sacrifice this, resolve the energy trigger, and I'm also going to sacrifice a puzzle knot with the Evolving Wilds on the stack still.
Right, so you go 17.
This is up to 6 energy. I go to 17, and then I'm going to activate spin. Marvel still with Evolving Wilds on the stack.
Yep, and this is still the beginning combat phase.
Yep. 4, 5, 6. Play Ulamog.
Tilt. Target.
And I will target your Array and your Liliana. Okay, and now I will search for a land.
Yep.
Kind of sweet stuff I got left. Not much, to be honest. Got an Ish. Ooh, and I got an energy off the legend rule.
Aw, I was hoping you missed that trigger.
What a jerk.
What? I'm just trying any way I can win, man. Tax?
Yeah, I'll attack for one.
All right, 21.
And I'll play an Inspiring Statuary.
Sure.
Go. Whoop. No pacification array. Is it a redraw?
No.
Liliana?
Yeah.
Sure.
What can we do here? We can minus our ballista. All right, we're going to go... I can maybe try to keep him off of Marvel activation next turn. That seems almost impossible, though. So we'll do one here. One to you.
Yep. 16.
Minus this, get it back, cast it for 2. Yeah, sorry, mill 2. Tezzeret, the Shemur. go.
How many cards in your deck?
Probably about 30.
Thirty-six.
Yep.
Okay.
You're gonna cut me right to a pacification array.
I hope not. guess we'll start by just cracking a puzzle. Okay, I'm going to tap this. Play this servant. Improvise.
Oh, right.
And then I'll sacrifice this puzzle knot. Go to 19 and 8 energy.
Oh, this is going to be a long video.
Actually, Marvel got a 2.
I should have conceded like 5 turns ago, but... I drew a pacification.
Ooh, going off.
Yep. So you get 2 more choppers.
Yep. And I'm going to attack your Liliana with a Ulamog.
All right, Liliana dies.
Okay. You lose 20 cards.
I'm pretty sure you didn't announce that trigger.
Today on the Scumbag Edition of the Versus video.
We shouldn't call that scumbaggery, because that's just tournament rules. I don't want people having a... it wasn't in there.
It wasn't in there?
It wasn't in there.
Okay. Go ahead. Redraw for the sweat?
Oh, it was a one-drop artifact, too. Oh. I just thought it was it. All right, you win. All right, I'm on the play for game two. My hand is not great. I think I'm going to keep it, though, just to hopefully see if I can just draw some interaction, I guess, but...
My hand is pretty sketchy because we just can't really cast anything right now. But if we draw a couple of lands, this hand is great. So, okay, well, that was probably best possible.
Tilt.
I'm just going to get an island. Or maybe I'm supposed to get mountain, actually. I think that makes more sense.
Ballista.
Mm-hmm.
Go. It is not very threatening as a 1-1. I will say that. Maybe I should just learn to only cast it as a 2-2. But in this matchup, I think I just gotta...
I don't know, like having a body to improvise and stuff is a thing. Alright, play my puzzle knot.
Alright.
Go.
One ya.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, we'll play a Lillian deuce, tick deuce. Up and try to get the ultimate status.
Alright.
One thing I do like about this deck is I feel like it deals with token stuff pretty well with Ballista and Liliana.
Go.
Attack.
Yep. 20.
Only hit you
21,
twice,
right? I'm sorry.
I was gonna say. Alright, take this up.
Mm-hmm.
Draw a card.
Yep.
Go. I'm at 19.
So. Doing this. Doesn't accomplish anything. Well, it could keep my thing alive. Probably no better opportunity to do it. Yeah, I'll harness lighting this.
Right. Shoot for one so you don't get no energy.
Yep. 20, get an island.
Big money, no whammies.
Think I just want to... Oh, this is really interesting, actually. So, my initial play was just going to be lead on this, but I could actually just do this into this. So, I'm pretty sure we're going to get rebuked. So, I think I like that. I'm going to play Marble.
All right. I got to counter it.
Yep. Go.
Even though I'm going to get Ishkanad next turn, we might be able to... get this Liliana ultimate off the.
Yep.
Well, we got lucky.
Oh, man.
That off the top.
Crap. Go.
Choosing to tap this for mana as opposed to improvising. Let me read all this real quick. Okay. I just want to make sure I know all the stuff he does.
Yep.
All right, so tick up, get my Ethereum cell, aka gold piece. took this up 7.
Yep.
And we can activate Puzzle Knot if we want next turn. We can also just sack this and draw 2 cards next turn. Go.
Kind of need to spike pretty hard here. Okay, don't think that's going to get any there. Well, let's see.
I think it's kind of cool that this plus this can cast Metallic Rebuke.
It can't, actually.
Why not?
Because you have to tap this to sacrifice it.
Oh, tilt. Come on, Ethereum Cell. You ain't no gold piece.
I guess we'll just play a Marvel.
Okay.
Cool.
Ooh.
Yeah.
This might be a fun one.
It's kind of like that.
All right.
He's 7 ultimate as well, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Just curious of whether or not I should pop this archive. I kind of don't know if I'll need the mana. Yeah, maybe I should just wait. All right, whatever. Draw. Let's make another Ethereum cell. Get a Liliana emblem.
Yep.
There's no reason not to just do this. 18.
Yep.
Oh, crap. Don't mind me.
Done goofed.
I'm bad at tapping lands.
Sure.
I don't think we're going to ever get to the point where we can double up on emblems. So
look at me trying to get an extra.
Maybe
energy.
I'll just get a little value out of this walking ballista. And play that. In a turn, get some zombies.
All right. Got a lot of things to beat.
Double plus two. If anything could do it, Ulamog could do it.
Maybe. Alright, we're going to sacrifice this, gain an energy. One, two,
all it takes is two three, attacks, usually to deck four. Somebody.
I actually think it's pretty close whether Thopterist or Lightning is better here, because like just containing a zombie stops the exponential growth, but because we have this, I think we should just play the Thopterist.
All right.
Or this goes in my hand. The difference between Vessel and Marvel is just messing with me. Okay, I'm getting Marvel Thopterist. Sorry about that.
That's fine.
Now activate Marvel.
Yep.
Okay, there's an Ulamog.
Tilt.
So, definitely taking out Tezzeret. Now, kind of what I was alluding to previously, I actually think it's very close whether we're supposed to take out a zombie or, like, Hedron Archive.
Sure.
But I guess we can just theoretically race the zombies, so we should probably just take out the archive.
I'm going to count my deck first, make sure two attacks gets me. Not positive. Seven. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13,
no, it's actually 14, close. 15.
It's only 15.
15?
So two hits will not give me unless I draw cards.
15, so 16, 17, 18, 19. That would still be off by one. It does change it a little bit. I'm at 20.
Yep.
So this is going to go up to 6 zombies and then 14 zombies.
Yep.
Yeah, I'll hit a zombie. Unclear whether that's right or not, but go.
All right. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
What?
Zap.
Really?
Yeah. Minus one, and then 3, 6, 7, 8, and then 2 Ethereum cells with 10.
What is the minus one?
Minus one toughness from her plus ability.
Oh.
He's a 10-10, right?
Yes.
So minus one, so he's a 9. Then 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
That's brutal. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Count this one more again.
6?
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
10.
That's pretty sweet. Good beats.
Yeah, so I gained 10. I'm at 28.
I gained an energy.
You do gain energy. And I'll thwack you for 2.
Okay.
And then in a turn, double plus 2.
Yep.
Your turn.
Okay. Sacrifice.
All right, 23.
I have myself a 21.
I had you down to 20 and then up to 20. I missed the 2 attack because I'm stupid. Too busy doing other things. Oh, wait. No, I didn't actually have to sack these. I just had to improvise these. I don't know what I'm doing.
Sure.
So I actually do get to keep them.
Well, whatever. Try again.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, I died.
No, you're not dead yet. You got one more turn.
I can't outpace it at this point.
Oh.
Okay. Because even if you go up to 10 tokens and I take out 2, and then I die on the following turn.
All right, I win. Yeah, I won.
By battle with the bridging.
That's a big old bridge.
I thought it was damaged, to be honest.
Nah.
Okay, back here for sideboarding. Basically, on my side, I'm getting a little... Well, I was going to say getting less combo-oriented, but I guess we're just getting combo-oriented in a different direction. This time, it's with Tireless Tracker making clues and using Inspired Statuary to tap those clues for mana so we can play our Worldbreaker and our Ulamox.
Yeah, it's a pretty sweet little transformation package. I think Inspiring Statuary just does a lot of cool stuff for a deck where, you know, you have the Marvels, and the only way you can cast an Ulamog feasibly is to play Inspiring Statuary, and you have all these kind of little cheapo beepo artifacts that let you do that, which is pretty sweet. And then Tireless Tracker plus that just seems awesome.
Yeah, so we got that little package to kind of backdoor into various Eldrazi that way. Some negates, just because it's kind of a standard control matchup. Yeah. We're replacing our Harness Lightnings, which are pretty ineffective against Todd. And then an Evolving Wilds, which helps get our blue mana and power up our Tireless Trackers. Going a little bit lower on the Marvel element, even though it's still in our deck with a couple Puzzle Knots. It's not something we necessarily want to be doing on turn 4. And then we kind of have to board out an Ulamog, even though I'm actually putting more ways in my deck to be able to hardcast it. It's just, I can't afford to have draws where I have various Worldbreakers plus Ulamog. So
yeah, my side, we're bringing a few counter spells to help interact with Marvel. I think my deck is decent at containing the rest of the threats out of the deck, assuming that he's not hard casting Marvel off of Statuary, which if he is, that's also problematic. Disallow and Negate both help contain some of the things. The Marvels coming out is a little awkward because my deck is not as prepared to beat Worldbreaker or Tireless Tracker card advantage. We could, after we see, you know, Tireless Trackers and Warbreakers in game 2, maybe bring in like some Kalidus or something. I'm not sure how good Tezzeret is just yet. I'm leaving him in the deck for now, but I might be bringing Kalidus over him after next game.
All right, back here for game 3. This hand is, it's really goofy. just the fact that we have a little bit of interaction makes me inclined to keep it.
Yeah, my hand is not great. Not in love with it. I would much rather prefer like another cheap artifact or something. But we are going to keep it in hopes that we draw something to interact in the first couple turns.
All right, I'm going to do this on turn 1. Go. Cool.
Go.
Go.
Your turn.
Okay. I'll play Attune with Aether.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna get an island and play Aether Hub and say go.
Okay. So island in hand, 2 energy.
Yep.
Alright. Weird. Or you have 3 energy, sorry.
Yeah, 3 energy.
I guess I'll just say go. Weird. Don't really want to get negated right there.
Goop.
I think I'm fine just hitting land drops. Go.
Yeah, I think this is just going to be a weird one. Go.
All right, Lily.
I really just don't want to let this resolve and just lose to it in like 4 or 5 turns, but... Yeah, negate.
Interesting. Okay. Go.
That's not bad. Vessel.
I'm gonna negate that. Mostly just because I don't have a way to deal with Ishkanan. I want to try to keep him from getting delirium.
Yeah, since I got nothing going on, I'm gonna fight back.
Okay.
Cool. I guess there's an argument for cracking it now because of disallow, but yeah.
True. Alright, I'm gonna play this.
Yep.
And
maybe I should respond with sacrifice. No, okay, that's fine.
Okay. Yeah, go.
Alright, sacrifice.
Yep.
3, 4. Tracker seems sweet to me.
Yeah.
pick, tracker.
I'll try to disallow it.
Negate.
All three negates?
Yeah, my hand was weird. It's my first draw step, and I kept aiming with two of them.
Okay.
Clue.
Yep.
Go.
All right, what can we do? All right, let's start with Tezzeret.
Yep.
Take up, make a... No, I'm not going to do that. So you can make him a three toughness.
Got two artifacts. That would suck.
Draw.
Don't hit. It looked like a man who needed to hit. I could be wrong.
That's fine. Take up this. And... there you go.
Sack my clue.
All right. I'm going to have to sack this to fatal push this.
Sure. Draw card.
Yep.
Okay. Kind of doing it.
Are you?
I should probably not tap that in the most rancid way possible. Okay. Stature.
Yep.
All right, improvise.
Yep.
Go.
Get two choppers. What can I do here? Not a whole lot. Tezzeret, you just feel so weird. All right, let's go. One, two, three. Four, five. And draw three.
Yep.
One, two, three.
That card seems fun to resolve.
Yeah. Hedron Archive.
It's coming off.
Magnifying glass.
Sure.
Minus on this. And go.
I'll play a tune.
Yep.
Get forest. I'm gonna cast Ulamog.
Yeah, that's the one that I can't beat. That's right. Forgot about that one.
I didn't realize all my stuff. I'm gonna target both archives, I think.
That's probably smart.
Go.
I don't have a way to get Ulamog off the battlefield, so I think I'm just dead. One, two. No.
Still got a ray in your deck.
Yeah. Not quite dead.
Yep.
Draw.
Yep. The sweats.
Let's see, so we can do
you trying to set up double Tezzeret? So close.
Hush you. Alright, yeah, we'll tick up,
yep.
Get a cell and play a walking ballista for two.
Sure.
And take a
All right, attack Tezzeret with all my creatures. Trigger.
All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Any tappers? No tappers. All right. Block, shoot.
Servant, get two energy, and go.
Got one card in hand?
Yep.
All right. Well, I guess
I should have played this last turn.
Play what? Sure. Sorry. All right. Minus five the Ulamog.
Yep.
Minus five the Ulamog.
Yep.
And play. This is your only creature in play?
Yep.
Okay, sorry. One, two, three. Play a Liliana, tick up on it.
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Go.
We're doing it.
Yeah.
We're doing it.
Kind of doing it.
Oh, we even drew it. I'm going to save it, though, in case you draw the Ulamog. That way it doesn't get snapped off. All right. Make thing.
Yep.
Plus on this.
Yep.
Six, seven, eight. Yeah, whatever. 9, 10. Make a 5/5.
Sure.
Go.
What am I supposed to do with this?
You draw an Ulamog?
No, not that good.
Thanks.
It's like hitting this doesn't seem like it accomplishes a whole lot, but maybe it just actually does. Alright, I'm gonna break off your Ballista.
Alright, two here, three you.
Yep.
I suppose. All right, so you're what? I don't even know what life you're at. I missed a bunch.
I'm at 20 now, I believe.
Because you've just gained the 3 and I haven't attacked otherwise?
Yes.
Am I still at 20 also?
To my knowledge.
Yeah, I don't think I gained any. I didn't puzzle knot.
Nope.
Okay.
Go.
Go.
Nope.
And draw. I should start investigating.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely a consideration whether I should kill that, but.
We'll go minus for this. And then. Take up here.
Mm-hmm.
Or I'll put them. Play this for. 3. Play this for 1.
Sure.
And go.
Combat.
All right, tap your Worldbreaker.
Go.
Is this in play or in my graveyard? I just knocked this off the table.
Pretty sure it was in. Oh, okay.
Graveyard? Oh, yeah, because I'm minus. Yep. Okay. All right. What'd you do? Tap land?
Yep.
All right, draw minus 1, 2, back this. Tick this up, get another thing. Attack for 3.
17.
Play this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4. And go. Mad dice.
Window is definitely closing. All right, that's a draw. Combat.
All right, tap it.
Okay. Casting Ulamog.
No. Ugh.
6. 7, 8, 9, 3, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay.
I guess Array and Tezzeret. Go.
All right. Well, I think I am dead unless I can somehow find a way to deal 17 damage this turn, which does not seem likely. So you block this one, you take 3.
4, 5, 6.
Yeah, it's not even close.
12.
6 plus 4 is 10. So, yeah.
I would take combat damage and then the six on the way out, so it's actually like one off.
Oh. Maybe I should have sacrificed these last turn. Has that done anything?
Four, eight, I definitely didn't do the math, so it's entirely possible.
Yeah, neither. Walking Ballista kills a lot faster than I think either of us really thought.
Yeah.
Maybe I can, like, upkeep shoot you some more. Let's see. No, that's still not enough.
It's entirely possible I should have just killed a Ballista. All
right.
So you could have...
19.
Yep.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
All right. Cast that for one.
Mm-hmm.
7. 14. 15. Yeah, I'm too short of actually just killing you right now. I guess took up on Worldbreaker.
Mm-hmm.
And say go.
Okay.
I feel like he drew another Ulamog.
I didn't. It could be an Ulamog.
Oh, could be anything.
Guess we'll just go ahead and do this now.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Not particularly great. Play Virtuoso, get 8 energy.
All right.
Move to combat.
Yep. I will tap your thing that kills me.
Reasonable. Oh, and this is a 3-6, right?
Yep.
All right. In that case, I'll just say go.
Okay, so in a turn, I can sack my 2 Ethereum cells to put a counter on a Ballista. I think I'm going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the bigger one. I don't know if it matters. Or no, I think they should
both be. It should be the smaller one, right?
Yep. All right.
It's been a really interesting game.
Draw. What to do? 4, investigate, crack. Do that. Still do that. All right. We're going to investigate and pop it.
Yep. So that's 6 mana, right?
6. Draw. Fatal push the Virtuoso.
So you have 3 mana left after that?
Yep.
And you haven't played a land?
I have not.
Feels like
I
should
believe
just...
so. Actually, I might have. So I... Yeah, I did. Because I had a card. I played my land. I'm sorry.
Feels like I should just make as many tokens as possible, but... Maybe that's not actually... there's probably just actually a solution to this. So, I guess even if Todd taps my Worldbreaker, that leaves him with potentially 2 mana. So this would be 8, 16, 17. That's worst case scenario. So maybe we should make 1 token. That way we still have an Aetherworks activation next turn. We can make up to 2 tokens and still have a Marvel activation.
Yep.
Well, the question is, if that's not good enough, then we have to do it again on the following turn. That is certainly a possibility at this point. You have 5 cards left. Alright, I'm for sure making 1 token, but then I'm going to try to figure out the rest.
Okay.
I guess the odds of us marveling into nothing relevant or something that doesn't make energy is quite low, but... I don't know. Alright, I'm just gonna let it die. Pretty sure this is safe. You can also just like Lily on this token if you really wanted to. But he can't push damage through the World Breaker unless he dies next turn.
So. Yeah. Yeah, this is not great. You just continuing to use your... Oh, man. Maybe that was just bad. Huh. Shoot that. Tick up on that. Attack with this. Yeah, sure, why not? All right, this.
Okay. Seven energy.
Yeah, this. Attack. That's stupid.
Well, yeah, then I can just...
Yeah, here. I'm just gonna, yeah. All right, go. Okay. No attacks.
I think we'll just go ahead and use this puzzle knot.
All right, so you're 20, and you go to a million energy.
Oh, yeah. It's potentially good. All right, go ahead and do this. 5, 6. I'll play a traverse. I just want to get another Ulamog. Can cast it. Kind of puts him to the test.
Yeah, I mean, I have to draw, or I don't think I actually have a draw left because one of my pacification rays is already gone.
Yeah,
could have a counterspell though.
It's true,
but it doesn't matter because this is gone.
I'll move to combat.
That's the thing that kills me.
And. Play Ulamog.
Targets.
Target array and I guess Lily has the most potential to deal damage because it can rebuy a ballista.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'll deal Lily.
Sure.
Gain another energy. And so go.
All right. Sufficiently Ulamogged. Almost.
So close.
So we're going to make a clue. I'm going to play this minus here.
Yep.
And then I'm going to be dead after I attack. All right, shoot for 4, so you take 7.
Yep.
You're at 13.
13.
You win.
Yep. Yeah.
All right, I'm on the play here for game 4. Down 2-1. Need to rally these last two to take the match. This opener is not particularly exciting. We could very easily mulligan it, but I don't know. I just have a feeling. I have a feeling like we're going to get there.
Over on my side, I took a mulligan to 6. The hand is perfectly fine, but I have no idea how we're supposed to sequence, so I think the scry will give us a little bit more information. It didn't really help. I think we want to bottom this. It's too weak to keep, but I'm pretty sure I want to save this card just in case we draw something.
Go.
Alright, that kind of fixes a lot of our questions, so I'll tune for a mountain.
Draw a card. Normally this would be the part in the video where I said, go through.
So you're saying you have a third land?
No, I already had... This was my second land.
Oh.
I drew the swamp. So I'm a miser.
Play a hub, get an energy. Servant, get an energy. Go.
That's not good. That's all sorts of not good. Yeah, this is all sorts of bad. Go.
Maybe. Ooh, perfect.
No.
Actually, it's man playing against Metalcorp is really scary. I mean, it was a good draw, though. Oh, I'm such a coward. I suck.
Cowards can't block warriors.
I hate this about myself. Attack you.
18.
I'm so lame. Go. Mm-hmm. Energy. Pay an energy. Play Thopterist.
Tilt. Okay.
Go.
Come on, deck. What do I do now? All right. Get an island. Play it. Play Belisa. Go.
All right. In this circumstance, I am fine with trading, I believe. So, question is whether I'm sending this or not. And I think it's pretty close. I'll attack with everything. Sure.
Take 5. 14 me.
13, right? 2 off this.
Was it 19? Maybe I was at 18. I don't know. Oh, I'm just from last game. I'm sorry. I'm 13. I was on the wrong column.
Play a virtuoso.
Okay.
Go. Beaten down.
Tezzeret.
Yep.
Minus on the verge, or no, I don't have enough to do that. Minus on this thing.
Mm-hmm.
Here you go.
I'm gonna make 2 Thopters, I think.
All right.
Okay, draw. And all of these creatures are going to attack.
Stack needs Yehenny's expertise. That card would be dope.
All these attack Tezzeret.
Alright, he down.
Tracker.
Yep.
Play Evolving Wilds.
Yep. Probably should have done that before you attacked because I could Fatal Push this. I guess it doesn't matter.
Oh, I can just say go.
Yeah.
Or you could pop this if you really wanted to.
Well, I don't really want to.
Well, I'm just going to say go then.
Fine. Man. Just getting whooped over here.
It's my little mid-range deck.
All right. Draw 3.
I'll respond. Sack this.
Okay.
You're good.
1, 2, 3. Play a choked estuaryville swamp. I'll play prophetic prism draw.
Yep.
There you go.
Second clue.
Yep.
Clue.
Yep.
Attack with all my creatures. All
right. This block's virtuoso. This target's Thopter.
and fatal push targets tireless tracker.
Sacrifice one clue. And I think I'm going to be fine with letting this resolve, not try to hit negate.
Okay. So you take four. I'm at nine.
All right. Vessel.
Yep.
And Sigurd.
Go to eight.
Yep.
Play Tezzeret.
Yep.
Minus your Virtuoso.
You're eight. Two, I'm three, eight. Four, five. Cards in?
I have four.
It's really possible. I just want to make a token, but that means I can't crack. I guess I can't crack a vessel, but it means I could crack my clue instead. It's close. Yeah, it's fine.
Alright, go.
Spend energy, sack my vessel.
Yep.
Three, four. Jeez. I think I just want to take. So I could take Tracker and just like play this very grindy game, but if I take Ulamog, then I'm kind of pressing Todd on two different fronts, where he has to deal with the board and the threat of Ulamog looming. And I still have Worldbreaker access, so I'm just going to take that.
I think if you had eight. Oh, no, you do have eight. Never mind. Okay.
And because I have Ulamog, I think I'm pretty comfortable just sending everything at Tezzeret. And I'm going to cast an attune.
I'm going to negate it.
That's reasonable.
Got to try to keep him off of 10, but I don't know if. I just been had this stuck in my hand the whole game.
All right, I'm going to play Traverse and cast Ishkanah.
Huh. All right, well, I don't have Wrath in my deck, so I'm pretty sure I'm just dead.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to get these negates out of my deck. After sideboard, he just has way too many creatures, I think. All right, we're here for the fifth and final game. I'm on the play with a very reasonable opener. Man, what's it feel like to just have turn one Renegade map? Feels pretty good.
Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
My hand's kind of just like a lot of early stuff and no payoffs yet, but nothing wrong with that.
Your turn.
Tune. Form an island.
Oh, we're both playing Lay of the Land over here. The cool thing about Renegade map is that you actually just never need to sacrifice it until you're going to miss your land drop. So yep. I don't have to crack it right now or anything. All right. Your turn.
All right. Play Serpent.
Yep.
Go. All
right. Play Liliana. Take up.
Yep.
Go.
All right. Looks like we're back on plan A.
Oh, no.
Go.
Why? Why didn't I just kill your creature? I'm so greedy. So greedy. All right, whatever. Minus. All right, is that... No. That might just be... All right, I guess there's enough things. Yeah, whatever.
It's really close.
Yeah, kill this.
Okay. Gain energy.
You gaining the energy, I think, is the big thing. But go.
Like, keeps me off red mana.
Yeah.
Just getting backdoor into a bunch of other.
It just it lets stuff. Servants turn on Aetherworks Marvel, which was a minor concern. I should have just killed your stupid servant on turn three, but I might end up winning anyway because Liliana ultimate.
That's possible. Right. Vessel, crack it.
Maybe that's why I shouldn't have killed it.
Actually, Servant and Tracker are pretty close here. Might just be Servant. Probably not going to have time to mess with these clues. Yeah, I think we're take. I just feel so weak though. So if we brick on Marvel, what are we doing next turn? I mean, if we brick, then we're probably like getting something with energy. So maybe the servant's just better. I'll take servant. You know, it feels kind of bad.
Sure.
All right.
Spin.
Activate. Let's go.
Nah.
Oh man, these negates ending up in my Marvel are not great.
Well, it's not Ulamog, so we're pretty happy right now. Literally, don't care about any other
card. All right, dude.
Sure. Shuffle them bad ones back in.
Yep. Get a forest. Go.
All right. Draw. Took up Ethereum Cell. Took up.
Mm-hmm.
Play land. Play this for four.
Yep.
And your turn.
Okay, just gonna. Maybe I shouldn't play this yet. All right, I'll play Whirler.
Okay.
Five. Servant.
Sure.
Go to one. Five, six.
World breaker target?
Yeah.
Yeah, world breaker, not Ulamog. Renegade map.
Target your ballista, I guess.
Alright, I'll kill the servants.
Go.
Alright, what can we do? All right. Minus here. And that's a tilt. All right, whatever. Plus here.
Yep.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Do this for 8.
Sure.
All right, 28. Go.
Oh!
Yes!
Oh, man. So I could just play this instead of attuning. Because it technically gives me a better chance of hitting Ulamog. I guess that's right. If nothing else really matters right now.
Nothing else matters.
I don't know. This might be just crazy, but...
I don't think it's crazy. Just making sure that you have a higher chance of hitting.
Oh, there it is.
So I could have, like, let my Lily take a chunk and then just, like, use this to counter this.
But... Yeah, well... I think that gives you a lower chance of winning the game. The
I do. I did too. That's why I did this. But all right, these two.
Yep. All right.
Well,
now I will cast my attune.
Sure. God, I hate Aetherworks Marvel so much. I want to just yell curse words.
But you're a professional.
I'm not that professional. All right, you win.
That's okay. Good.
All right, so not a great showing for the black-blue Tezzerator deck. Not being able to deal with an Ulamog or even a resolved Aetherworks Marvel, not a good idea, I don't think.
Yeah, I kind of agree. But I don't know if there's any real solutions for an archetype like that.
I mean, you could just play Grixis instead and then play, like, Release the Gremlins or whatever. Like, there are things you can do. Adding another color to help out is certainly one of them. I mean, even just recognizing that weakness and maybe sideboarding a couple copies of Ceremonious Rejection is even, sure, you know, whatever. But, yeah, there's... A lot of weird stuff going on in Sander right now, though. You know, like we're still trying to process the bans. We're still trying to figure out what new cards are good at the same time as processing the bans. You know, we basically have to reevaluate a year and a half worth of cards just because now everything's so much different. You know, and Emrakul invalidated so many things. Reflector Mage invalidated so many things. Smuggler's Copter made it so that sorceries were bad. So, you know, we just basically have to come back and figure out all these things again. It's really, really difficult.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I do think Tezzeret looked pretty powerful. It ultimates really quickly. It kind of, it gives you a bunch of mana. It kills stuff.
I think it is fine. It was not great. Minusing was good.
I don't know. Like, I think maybe that was just, like, a side effect of the rest of the deck not working well in this matchup.
I mean, that's certainly possible. I don't think the ultimate's very good.
It's threatening.
Like,
it's fast.
It is threatening. And the fact that you go tick up, and then you can ultimate is pretty sweet. And not a whole lot of planeswalkers can do that. So that is something to keep in mind. The minus ability, pretty good. The plus ability, okay. Sure. I wouldn't say that I really enjoyed it too much. I think it's better if you were ramping to something, not having a bunch of little things that cost you know, mana every single turn. Like, it doesn't seem that good with Walking Ballista or, you know... Magnifying Glass.
Yeah,
that was called.
Yeah.
But you know, if you are trying to hit, you know, like a 7, 8, 9 drop or whatever, like, it's pretty sweet. You know, you could build a bug Tezzeret deck that plays Worldbreaker, and you go, sure, Tezzeret into tick up Worldbreaker.
Yeah, I mean, this deck has a lot of potential to splash. You can play. I mean, you have Prophetic Prism. You have Tezzeret. You have Renegade Map. You could play Spire of Industry.
Yeah, I mean, I felt like I had a free splash basically, and because I had Prophetic Prism. What, two or three out of the five games, and I never activated it one time.
Sure.
And I think the mana can be stretched a little bit to try to fit another color. And whatever color that may be, I don't know yet. Maybe two colors. Have some fun, I guess.
Yeah, you could just... Your blue requirements aren't even really hard at all.
No, and you could also just build the decks in a little bit a different direction. And if you trim a lot of the... Like, you trim the disallows out of the sideboard, you know, you don't have the old blue on anything. And then, you know...
Sort of reverse engineer, I guess.
Sure, but I mean, there's only one of, and it didn't even feel that good. Like, maybe if the deck had a few more cheap artifacts, but there aren't a lot of great ones, and I think that's kind of the problem.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, there's just so much room to explore with Tezzeret kind of decks.
Yeah.
So.
All right, guys. Well, that's going to be all for me and Michael today. Yeah. Aetherworks Marvel's still good.
Yeah, well, I think the direction that I took was fine. Hard to say if it's the best thing, but I think... Just being able to be
you
a small ball
so much.
Deck.
You whiffed so much and still beat the crap out of me. Also, my deck didn't do anything.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't really under pressure except right. for planeswalkers, but
yeah, I mean that's fair. I do think that the Aetherworks Marvel, the card is still perfectly fine, and
for sure.
I am still going to hate playing against it for the next year and a half, 2 years or whatever. So just keep that in mind. Just take it with a grain of salt. I'm just gonna complain about it a lot. Yeah. What are you going to do?
It is what it is.
All right. Thanks for watching the Verse Series on StarCityGames.com. For Michael Majors, I'm Todd Anderson, and we'll see you later this week.